Welcome to Blackboard Basics for Faculty, a sabbatical project in collaboration with the Faculty Center for Student Success at Saddleback College. This is a 7-part video series, and today we will cover Part 2, Welcome to Blackboard, your first Blackboard shell. These videos are specific to the South Orange County Community College District, but they are designed to help everyone using Blackboard. The Blackboard interface used in these videos is version 9.1. Interface design changes with certain updates, but many of the items covered in these videos have remained constant or been improved with each update. These videos are to help faculty who teach face-to-face classes use Blackboard to enhance their courses. If you are a student looking for Blackboard help, please see Blackboard Basics for Students, linked below. In Part 2, Welcome to Blackboard, your first Blackboard shell, we will cover 1. Creating a presence in your Blackboard course. 2. Different teaching styles and course navigation. 3. Banners and templates. Number 1. Creating a presence in your Blackboard course. Ideally, you want your Blackboard course to be an extension of your face-to-face course. Think of how you organize your face-to-face class and see if that can be mirrored in your Blackboard course. This will help you to organize the course menu / navigation menu in Blackboard and help you create a Blackboard course that has a little of your personality in it. Navigation menus can be organized in Blackboard, so they help to enhance your face-to-face class. Number 2, different teaching styles and course navigation. We all have different teaching styles, but there are a few things we almost all use. The items like syllabi, assignments, contact information, and student grades. I would also add announcements and resources and links to a Blackboard course. Using these key items, we now have a list to make our Blackboard navigation menu. Inside our Blackboard course, we will now make a navigation menu. To make a Blackboard navigation menu link, go to the plus sign in the course in the top left corner. Click this plus sign and then content area to get started. Type in syllabus, check available to users, and click submit. Now repeat that process and create an assignments area. This time don't check available to users. This means you will be able to see the link, but your students will not. Then click Submit. Here you can see the two items we have created. The assignment link has a box with a line through it next to it. This means it is not available to users. To make it available, click the pull-down arrow next to the link and click Show Link. Now we will make the contact information. For this, click the plus sign, then choose Tool Link. Under Type, choose Contacts. Type in contact information or contacts, check available to users, and click Submit. Repeat the Tool Link process for announcements and My Grades. Name your link, check available to users, and click Submit. Now create the last navigation link by going to the plus sign, clicking content area, name the link resources and links, check available to users, and click submit. Congratulations! We have created a navigational menu for your Blackboard course. Now let's clean it up a little. These top three items were here when we opened the course, and we are not going to use them. Let's delete them. Scroll over these items, click the pull-down triangle, and click Delete. Blackboard asks you if you are sure you want to delete this item, and you are, so go ahead and do it. Delete the other items we did not create as well. Now you should just be seeing the navigation menu items we created. Let's organize them a little. I like the announcements to be the top of the menu, and there are two ways to do this. The first is to drag the item in the menu to the position you want it to be in, like this. And the second way to organize the menu is by clicking on the up-down arrows near the plus sign. By clicking on these arrows, we can organize all the menu items at once. In this case, I move resources and links above my grades and click submit. You can also create dividers and subheaders under the plus sign. These can be moved just like the menu items. In this case, I created a divider. Number 3, banners and templates. Now that we have our navigation menu, let's start with banners and course themes. A banner is going to help identify your class visually. You can create banners in a variety of programs and then upload them to Blackboard. Any program where you can create a PNG or JPEG will work for banners in Blackboard. The recommended banner size from Blackboard is 480 by 80 pixels. When you create a banner, take into account laptop screens and mobile devices. Banners should be PNG or JPEG files. I created a banner in Photoshop for this video. To upload a banner and create a course theme, we need to go to Control Panel, Customization, Teaching Style. I'm going to start on number 2, Select Course Entry Point. This is the page that students will see first when they enter your Blackboard course. You can choose any page, but the page must have content in it for it to show up on this list. As soon as I have content in mine, I will switch this to the announcement page. Next, you can go to number 3, Select Course Theme. Here you can select one of the themes Blackboard has provided. They are divided by color, structure, and subject. I choose the digital learning theme for these videos. Select Menu Style. Here you can select if you would like your menu to have text or buttons. If you choose text, you can pick the background color and text color. The preview will show you what it looks like. If you choose the buttons, you can then expand the button library and decide your button type, solid pattern or striped, button shape, rounded corners, rectangle or rounded ends, and then button color. My only word of advice here is to make sure you keep things accessible for your students. Some students have problems with color blindness and other visual obstacles, so try to make sure your menu options are clear to everyone. I click Text Style and move on to number 5. Number 5, Default Content View. I leave the icon and text button clicked. Number 6, Select a Banner. I have created a banner for my course and I upload it here. I click Browse My Computer and attach the file. Then I click Submit. This is what I have created. One way to kind of see how your course will look to students is by clicking the Edit mode in the top right of your course. When the Edit mode is on, you, the instructor, see everything. When the Edit mode is off, you see things closer to how your students will see them. In this case, some of our menu items have disappeared. That is because items that don't have content in them are not visible to students. As our course is still unavailable to students, see Blackboard Basics Part 1 video for that, this is the closest we can get to seeing what our class will look like. Students do not see the course management control panel in their Blackboard view at any time. This completes Part 2, Welcome to Blackboard, your first Blackboard shell. We covered number 1. Creating a presence in your Blackboard course. Number 2, different teaching styles and course navigation. Number 3, banners and templates. Our course went from looking like this to this. Thank you so much for joining me for Blackboard Basics for Faculty, using Blackboard to enhance a face-to-face class. Leave any questions or comments below, and I will do my best to get back to you. please join me for part 3, where we will cover announcements and the syllabus.